Today I'm going to be cooking something different. I've never done a cooking ASMR video before, so I figured I'd try it. I was sitting down and I was like, okay, I gotta make dinner, but I also have to make an ASMR video, so I figured why not combine the two? So I'm just gonna be making some sweet and spicy beef. This is a recipe that I got from Blue Apron. It's not a sponsored video, just in case you're wondering, but I do like Blue Apron, so it's kind of like a freebie on me. But yeah, I get deliveries from Blue Apron every once in a while, and I make some of their recipes. They have a lot of good recipes, but they are pretty complicated, but they can be worth it. It's pretty delicious. You get like restaurant quality meals. So this recipe dresses up hearty beef with Thai flavors, including a spicy sweet sauce, fresh herbs, crispy shallot, traditional Thai garnish. They're using a hot bird's eye chili and honey to make the sauce, which lends some of this exciting flavor to a bed of jasmine rice. So I'm gonna have to cook the rice, prepare the ingredients, the shallot, vegetables, and finally cook the beef. So I'm just gonna go step by step, and we're just gonna have some fun. First, we gotta cook the rice. So I have to remove the honey from the refrigerator to bring to room temperature, which I already did. Then I'm gonna have to combine the rice and a pinch of salt and 1 cup of water in a small saucepan. Heating to boiling on high. Once it's boiling, I'm gonna have to cover it, reduce the heat, cook 12 to 14 minutes or until the water has been absorbed and the rice is tender. Turn the heat off and fluff, cook with rice. So I'm just gonna do that real quick and cut that out because the rice part is gonna be pretty boring, not very relaxing. So I'll skip that part and we'll go straight to me cutting the produce and everything. So hold on 1 second. Okay, so I got the rice going. So now we're just gonna switch the camera view, and I'm gonna start cooking everything. Okay, so it's a little bit messy, so please excuse me for that, but I have quite a bit of material to fit on one workspace, so I'm gonna have to make do with what I have because I have my laptop next to me, because I'm recording using it, so. But I got some sweet peppers. I have some cilantro and mint. Have a lime, a shallot, squash, some scallions, and some golden mountain sauce. Not really sure what that is. And then the nutrition information. And I think I also need garlic, so I'm just gonna grab that real quick. Okay, so I got the garlic. There we go. So now we have to thinly slice the shallot, placing it in a medium bowl. So I wish I had made more room for this. I'm just gonna have to start moving some stuff out of the way here. So, the peeled shallot. I'm not very good at working with shallots, not that familiar with essentially, I guess, kind of like an onion. Usually what I do is I just take whatever part is convenient, cut it off, and then just peel it like that. And that seems to work pretty well, usually. Yeah, these things will make you, like, tear up like a son of a bitch. Sometimes worse than onions. Usually red onions kind of really get me going with the tears. I'll also be periodically throwing stuff in the trash, so don't know if I'm gonna cut it out or not, but if you see jump cuts or me stepping away, you'll know why. This one now. sure you can see it properly. Okay, so we've got the shallots. Now we need to thinly slice them. Okay, now we have to thinly slice the shallots. I think. Okay. Just do that. Oh yeah, I feel it already. Ooh, my eyes are stinging a little bit. Oh man, that burns. So I'm just going to get these guys out of the way. Just make this a little bit smaller. You can see. I think that's good. Wow. It's a good thing you can't see my face. Let me just put this in a bowl over here. Just going to scoop this up and get it out of the way. I would have an ASMR cooking show if I could. I think that'd be really relaxing. I like to cook. And I like ASMR, so, I mean, it's a win-win. I have to keep referring to the directions periodically. Large dice the squash. So, that should be simple enough. Here's the squash. Take off the stem part here, and I gotta large dice it. So I will just cut them up into little cucumber type slices first, and then I'll dice them from there. Now, if any of you are professional cooks, please give me advice. Please give me advice and tips on, you know, any sort of dishes or cooking tips or anything you got that you think might help me when cooking in the kitchen. You know, anything that's delicious is also welcome. Willing to try that. I think these are, you should maybe have them. It'd be easier to do. That rice smells really good. I'm not a big like rice guy either. I feel like it tastes really plain, but this smells really good. Nice stats. Alright, get this guy out of the way. Okay. So I did that. Cut off and discard the sweet pepper stems half lengthwise, and then remove and discard the ribs and seeds. The ASMR portion of the video right here. Okay. Enough of that. Let's open this bad boy up and just move these guys kind of to the side here. So I'm going to take off the stems here. Okay. Take the stems out of the way. Lengthwise and then crosswise. so take the little seeds out. I actually like the seeds, I don't mind them. I know that's probably weird for me to say, but that's how I feel. So I will leave them, because I don't mind them. Plus, less work. So, there you go. Oops. This one's a little tougher to slice. Now, the last thing you guys want to see is me slicing my finger. That's not very relaxing, so I'm going to have to take it easy. Don't worry, if I chop my finger off, I'll just edit that portion out. You won't even know. I'll wrap it in a band-aid, go to the hospital after I finish recording, and, you know, life will move on. You'll never know. My video will be just as relaxing as ever. Okay. I got that. Now they want me to... Let's see... Cut off and discard the root end of the scallions, thinly slice, separating the white bottoms and the green tops. This is a pretty common practice in Blue Apron. They make me do extra work by separating the scallion parts, which sounds easier than it actually is. Alright, got that there. Usually, I would have like three different workspaces, but since my laptop is taking up so much space, it's kind of hard for me to do. So I got forced to kind of make compromises here. Alright, so now I gotta cut off the ends of the scallions, the white parts. I gotta thinly slice. Let's do it this way first. I've done this before, so I kind of have an idea of what they're asking for. They're a little ambiguous with some of these parts. Not sure if they're green or white. Oops. Right. You might have noticed. This is a very meticulous process, and that is one of the downsides of these recipes. It takes a long time. It's not good to do, just got out of work and yeah, it's like an hour and a half cooking process, so hence the ASMR video. Alright, peel and roughly chop the garlic. Where's my garlic? Here it is. Alright. Separate. Hope they want me to do something with these guys sooner rather than later because I'm running out of space. Alright. Peel and roughly chop the garlic. Alright. One could say that this is also a tutorial on how to cook if you're not a good cook. If the only thing you know how to make is a bowl of cereal, then, well, this might be a little too advanced for you. You might want to start with something a little easier first. But if you're at least at ramen level, then I think this is for you. Right. Roughly chop the garlic. At least they don't want me to mince it, because that can be a pain in the ass to do. Mincing garlic is, yeah. Let me move this a little closer. Mincing garlic can be a pain in the ass. Meticulous process. Alright. Usually I cook with my girlfriend, so I have to mince the garlic regardless of what the recipe says, because she doesn't like big pieces of garlic, which I don't mind. So since she's not here, I can make the garlic a little bit bigger, and I won't have to worry about any backlash. Alright. Next. quarter the lime. That's an easy, easy one. Come on, Blue Apron. Gotta give me something a little bit more, complicated. Alright. 4 pieces of freshly cut lime. I do like limes quite a bit. My girlfriend introduced me to Corona and lime. I know, I'm late, but wow, it's good. Lime plus beer, excellent combination. So good. It's so simple, but yet it just works, you know? Okay, so now I gotta pick the cilantro and mint leaves off the stems, discard the stems, then I gotta... I thought I did this already, but... Oh, there's a chili pepper here somewhere. I didn't see it. You know what? I may have combined the chili pepper and the other pepper. Whatever. Doesn't matter. I never claimed that I was going to stick to the recipe 100%. So I'm going to pick the stems. Okay. That's easy. That's easy. Let's go take this out. And I'm just going to... Basically, we have to take these guys out, which is an easy process to do. If you have time. If you're, you know, cooking and you gotta be in bed by a certain time, otherwise your productivity suffers, then well, you might be in a little bit of a rush to get this done. Also, don't do it right after you quarter a lime because they will stick to your fingers, like I'm learning this currently. I don't know how many cooking ASMR videos you guys have watched, but probably never watched someone as incompetent as myself do these. Usually it's probably a very pretty girl that has a beautiful kitchen and a very controlled demeanor. Well, no, not me, my friends. Not me. I gotta wash my hands. Hold on. Probably noticed already that I don't have a very professional presentation, shall we say. I'm very down to earth and kind of just do my thing, you know. It's not very rehearsed or staged, so if you like that sort of thing, then well, that's good, because there's a lot of staged videos already on the internet. We don't need another one, you know what I mean? Just doing my thing, keeping it casual. Keeping it cash. Alright. God damn. I picked all this shit off already. So much work. You know, like, really, if you think about it realistically, all I really have to do, I can just put the meat, the beef in a pan, the rice, done. You know? Don't need to do all this crap right here. Too much work. But it'll add some flavor, I know. Flavor. After handling the chili pepper. You know, I still don't know what they're talking about. I don't see a chili pepper here. I'm starting to think that they did not give me a... Oh, here it is. Wow, okay. Chili pepper. I'm stupid. Got it. So what did they say to do that? Cut off and discard the stem of the chili pepper, thinly slice into rounds. Thoroughly wash your hands after handling the chili pepper. Alright. Read you loud and clear. Wow. Read you round and clear, Raggy. Alright, into rounds. I'm gonna do that. I don't know how big they're supposed to be, though. Okay, thinly slice. So I'm gonna try to do this as thin as I can. Alright. Wow, that is strong. Wash my hands. right, so this is probably the hardest part of the entire thing, I would say. Add the flour to the bowl of shallot, seasoned with salt and pepper. Toss the thoroughly coat in a large pan, heat a thin, okay. And this is what's good about this service, is they kind of give you all the measurements, so you don't have to worry. You know, they give me a little bag of flour here. I've got my bowl of shallots. It's a really simple process. You don't have to, you know, whip out the measuring cups and everything like that. It really makes it easier, so. Let me see if I can record this process for you guys. I'll do as best as I can. I think I have to like separate these guys a little bit though. Give me 1 second. Need to make sure all these shallot guys are separated. I don't know exactly what they're supposed to look like, but yeah. Here's the bowl. Just put a little bit of flour there. Or all of it, rather, I should say. Not a little bit, all of it. Oh, man. Apologize for the terrible camera angles. There you go. Just all of it there. There we go. Okay. Nice, nice, nice. Now I have to, what did I have to do? Season with salt and pepper, toss the thoroughly coat. Alright, so let me do that. Just a little bit of salt. Just a little bit of pepper. Let me just put this down here because I need to actually, that. Now I can just thoroughly mix it together, the shallots and the flour. Usually I would do it with my hand, but since I'm recording, I need to actually touch some of the equipment. Rather, not have my hands covered in flour or wet. Okay, so there we go. It's kind of mixed effectively there. Let me put that away. So next, what we're going to do is we're going to heat a thin layer of oil. Once the oil is hot enough, next what we're going to do is we're going to heat a layer of olive oil, and we're going to add the shallots to it. Okay, so I apologize for the amateur camera angle, but I am not a professional, so, you know, bear with me. Alright, so I'm gonna put the pan down. This is the slowest and most carefully I've ever cooked, because I don't want to make a lot of noise. Usually I would be banging and making a mess everywhere, so maybe I should do this more often. A little bit of olive oil there, or a lot. This thing is not controlled at all. I also have some coconut oil that I bought today. Gonna try it out. Apparently coconut oil is good for you, so. Alright. So it says to test. How hot it is by placing a shallot on there. Seems pretty good. Alright. I'm gonna put the shallots now. Okay. Just check if I need to put some salt and pepper. too much flour in retrospect. Just let that cook for a little bit. Once I finish this, I'm going to have to transfer it to a paper towel lined plate, season with salt and pepper, and then we're going to have to rinse out the pan. I'm going to have to put 2 more teaspoons of olive oil in the pan. I'm going to add the squash and the sweet peppers. I'm going to cook for 3 to 4 minutes, or until it's brown. I'm going to turn off the heat, stir in the green tops of the scallions. Season with salt and pepper. Transfer that to a bowl, wipe out the pan. After that, I'm gonna heat 2 more teaspoons of olive oil. I'm gonna add the ground beef. I'm gonna season with salt and pepper. Cook frequently. Cook frequently, breaking the meat apart, 3 to 4 minutes or until it's brown. I'm gonna add the garlic, the white bottoms of the scallions, the honey, and the golden mountain sauce, juice of 2 lime wedges, 2 tablespoons of water, and as much of the chili pepper as I'd like, so all of it. So you can see I'm gonna forget like half of what I just said, so I don't know why I just read all of it, but hopefully it added some of the ASMR factor for you guys. I don't know if these scallions are done yet. Or shallots, I should say. Scallions. Come on, Randall. Focus. Focus. I'm also periodically checking my camera to make sure that the view is decent. Okay. I think these are good. What do you guys think? They seem like they're good. Alright, let me just make the switch. Test it out. Yep. Add the rest. So I just gotta cook this 3 to 4 minutes, or until lightly brown. After that, I'm gonna turn off the heat, stir in the green tops of the scallions with some salt and pepper. And then we get to the main event, the beef. some salt, some pepper. Mix that bad boy together. Oh yeah, that's looking good. Then we just transfer this over and we can start with the main event. Here we go. Now it's time for the main event. What we've been waiting for all along. The beef. Oh yeah. Break this apart a little bit. I have been thinking about getting a subscription to ButcherBox, also not sponsored. It's a service I heard about that delivers fresh grass-fed cuts of beef to your house every month for $129, I think it is. You get to have like a month's worth of meat. I think it might be well worth the investment. Because sometimes I go to the grocery store and like you don't really know if that meat is actually organic, grass-fed. At least not the supermarket, you know, meat that's from the butcher. If you don't care about grass-fed, then that doesn't really matter, but... I've been trying to take that initiative to eat more grass-fed meats and organic meats, things like that. Right. Just gotta cook this for 3 to 4 minutes and then we add everything else. Now this recipe, by the way, makes 2 servings, so... one serving of this is about 700 calories, which is a little bit high, given the portion size, but, it is good. So you don't want to eat 2 servings, because that's going to be well over 1,000 calories, which is a lot for one sitting, for one meal. You know what I realized? I mixed up the scallions. I used the white bottoms for the peppers and such when I should have used it for the meat here. So I messed up already. Too late. I just flew out. Chili peppers. Gonna have to do this instead. Use the green tops where the white bottoms were supposed to be used. It just doesn't taste good. Okay, it looks like we're done. Thank you for sticking out this long process with me. I'm gonna put the plate together and I'll show you the results. Okay, so here it is, the finished dish. You can see all the peppers and the zucchini, the beef, the rice, the shallots, the lime wedge on the side. Looks pretty good. So yeah, that took a while, but I think it's going to be worth it. I'll let you guys know in the comment section how it tasted. But yeah, until then, my friends, thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. This is Voice of Persona. Take care.